So hi guys, today I'm going to explain how to fix the battery drain issue of your gaming laptop. So to do this video, specifically I'm going to use my gaming laptop, which is my Victus 15 gaming laptop by HP, and the model number is FB1013DX. So when we are talking about the laptops, we must mention the model numbers because you have to know which kind of model that I'm using. So that's why I mentioned my model number. So this video is not just a random video about how to fix the battery draining issues of your gaming laptop. So you must try all of the basic instructions or the basic videos on YouTube before arriving at this. But I also tried all other videos on YouTube, but those things didn't fix the battery draining issue of my brand new gaming laptop, right? So firstly, give me a couple of minutes to explain the problem first, because I had to specifically explain my problem to you to understand if my problem and the problem of yours is same, right? So just give me a couple of minutes. So I got my HP Victus brand new gaming laptop in the month of Black Friday from the Best Buy, because it has some kind of a discount of $400 off on this laptop, and I just need to pay $428 or something like that, and its actual price of this thing is $700 or $800 maybe, I don't know exactly. So after buying this my gaming laptop, the first issue that I noticed is the heavy battery draining. Simply after installing the updates, drivers and the firmware, and after updating the BIOS, didn't fix my issue of the battery draining. It drains about to 18 to 22 watt at idle mode when I'm using my laptop. So it's just given 2 hours or 2.5 hours of battery backup. So it's very poor thing to a brand new gaming laptop. So I keep telling to the HP to fix my issue through the HP support center. So they simply provide me a good support to fix my laptop issue. They tried to fix my laptop through agents by online accessing through to my laptop, and they tried to figure out what's the problem with the battery. So they just do some random tests, and they asked me to do some battery tests and battery calibrations, and after all of that, the problem still exists. So they told me to do a cloud recovery, which is to install the stock version of my gaming laptop. So I just did the cloud recovery option with support of the online agents of the HP. So that also didn't work. So I did every single thing which told by the agents. It also didn't fix my problem, unfortunately. So after some days, HP agents called me. It's not the software issue, it may be the case of hardware, and they also guaranteed it is definitely a hardware malfunction or something like that, right? So they told me it is a hardware issue, then told me to bring the laptop to the headquarters, then they can give some warranty period and fix my laptop, and it can be returned to myself. Even I just bought it from Best Buy. So they already told me how to export my laptop and all that stuff, and it's very supportive thing about HP, but I just don't want to give my brand new laptop to United States because it's some kind of a time consuming thing. So I think it maybe take 1 month or 2 months to return my laptop and return it back to me. So it's very time consuming, so I don't want to do that, right? So I already gave up on that thing and started to use my laptop normally, plug into the power source and just use my laptop just like a desktop, right? So because it's just give me a 1 to 2 hour of battery backup. So finally I found the solution, and I found the solution very randomly, and I don't know, maybe it's my luck or something like that. So I just found the solution randomly, and I don't know about you, but I do a lot of things to fix my battery draining problem, like installing the HW info, hardware info, to my laptop and check the battery draining voltage by every second, and then I try to turn off my Wi-Fi adapter because it's Wi-Fi 6, and again check the battery drain, do the checks after turning off the battery saver mode, turning on the battery saver mode, and try to fix it by going to the control panel and try to adjust the power settings and limit the CPU usage and change the power plan and all of those stuff that you can simply find in the internet and on the online videos, I just did all of these things, but none of them works for me. So that's a very unfortunate situation, but finally, I think I found the solution thanks to some kind of a virus or something like that, right? So that's a very lucky thing. Let me explain the solution, and because I cannot do the same thing again because I fixed my laptop, so I cannot break it and do the same thing again. So I can explain how to fix your laptop, but you have to try the basic solutions in the YouTube videos or the internet. It may be solve your problem. So if didn't, do this, right? But I want to tell you this, the solution works for my Victus 15 laptop, and I don't know, I don't have pretty sure if the solution surely help other gaming laptops like Asus stuff or whatever it is, the other gaming laptops, okay? But you can try it because the solution is not an extremely hard thing to do, right? So let's go to the solution. So how to fix the battery draining issue of your gaming laptop? So very simple thing, and I don't know if you tried this or not, but the only thing you had to do is just a clean install of the operating system, and do not install the graphic drivers through the Nvidia GeForce Experience app. So it looked like a dumb thing or a stupid thing when I'm saying this, but it solved the problem, right? Simply what I did after getting the virus into my laptop, I simply go to the Windows and Microsoft website and download the latest Windows version, which is Windows 11 23H3, I guess, version, and it is 6.69 GB, I think. So after downloading the relevant ISO file, you can create a USB bootable drive, and you will go to the boot menu and install the Windows 11 to your laptop. Please remember these instructions when you're installing the Windows. So when you are going to the install Windows 11, you will see a screen like this, and you will see lots of disk partitions which is related to the HP or the relevant motherboard actually, and the system and recovery image, all of these things, right? You must delete all of these things and make sure it will look like this, right? Disk zero, unallocated space and total size in it, right? So if it is you have a 500 GB SSD or a 500 GB hard drive, you will see a 466 GB of space as total, and after that you can click the new button and it will automatically create the relevant disks. So make sure it totally wiped out all the data in your laptop, right? So that's the basic thing, and that's the important thing you have to remember when installing the clean install of Windows 11. So after installing, and I think you know how to perform a clean install to a Windows 11. So if you don't know, please go refer the previous videos of my channel and you will get an idea. So after installing the Windows 11 completely, you have to go to the Windows and go to the settings, and you have to go to the Windows updates, and you have to click the check for updates button, right? So I already got some updates. You have to click the check for updates button in here, and you have to download all the updates and all the Windows updates showing right here. So right, so after installing all of these updates, and go to the advanced options, and you have to go to the optional updates as well. So if you see any updates in here, you have to install all of these updates as well, right? So after installing all of these Windows updates, again click the check for updates button, and again install if any updates come. So repeat this process till you didn't get any update, right? So make sure you don't have any updates. You don't get the graphic drivers which is related to a dedicated graphic card, which is Nvidia GeForce or maybe another thing, right? So now you need to download the relevant graphic card to yourself, because we are not going to use the Nvidia GeForce Experience app. Before that, you have to download and install the relevant other drivers which is providing your company, right? So in my case it is HP, so I'm going to search like HP driver updates. So I'm going to the official HP page, and so if you create a HP account, you will see your device like here. So just click your device and you will get the relevant drivers, right? So it's Windows 11. You can select the OS version Windows 11 and click the submit, and you will see all the relevant drivers you need to install and download it, right? So you can simply download all of these things, BIOS system, firmware, diagnostic, driver audio, and do not download the driver graphics, which is the NVIDIA driver, right? So if you download this file and install it, it will install the NVIDIA GeForce Experience app, which is caused this much of trouble. So do not download this one, and you can simply download any other driver in here, right? So have a doubt, so how we can download the NVIDIA graphics driver? So let me show you. So just go to the Google and type RTX 2050 driver, and so which is in my case. So if you have another graphic card or another type of graphic card, you can simply type the name of the your graphic card and search it. RTX, it's a 3050 or 3060 or whatever it is. You can simply type the name of the graphic card, and after type you can drivers, right? Go to the first link in the search result, which is the official page of NVIDIA, and you can simply select the version of yourself. So in my case, this is GeForce. I'm going to select GeForce and say it is the GeForce RTX 20 series, which is a notebook version. So the product is the GeForce RTX 2050, yes. And the operating system is Windows 11, yes. And the which is my downloading type. So if you want the GRD version or the SD version, you can simply select whatever you want and simply click it. And the language is English, yes. And you can simply click the search button, and it will show the relevant gaming GeForce game ready driver. So you can simply click the download button and download and install the driver that you want. So it's simple as that. So let me show the result of all these heavy works, right? So I'm going to switch to my mobile phone to show the battery backup of my laptop right now. So I'm going to close this. Okay, now you can see the battery discharge rate. It is 10, and when in the previous case I got up 18 to 22 wattage of a discharge rate. Now I got a 11 discharge rate, which is great, and this is the estimated time, which is 288, because I'm using this 20% 25% of the display brightness. So it's not the case, because it's just I open the Chrome, right? So after closing the Chrome, and you will see the drop of the discharge rate, right? So you can see it is 15, and you can see it is 6.6, right? It is the ideal voltage or discharge rate of a normal laptop, right? So even if it's a gaming laptop, lots of friends and lots of things, lots of persons studying, the ideal usage of a gaming laptop, it is higher than a normal laptop. But you can see now it's turned to the normal rate, right? So which is superb, right? That's what we need. So you can see it is still in the 100, and I don't know why is that. The most of HP laptops just do not go to the 99%. It simply dropped to the 93 or 94% after some time. So let's see how much time we got to drop the 3% or 6% battery drop, right? So I'm going to do the turn off the Wi-Fi and turn on the battery saver, and I'm going to remove the all other unnecessary background apps, which is my recorder. So I'm going to exit it, and the rain meter, so exit it, and the translucent my custom taskbar, so I'm going to quiet it too. So now you can see how much I got. Now you can see it is 4.7, right? So it's 4.2, 4.5, and you can see it. So how much battery backup I got, right? And see, now its estimated time is 700 minutes, right? So 700 minutes, it's mean the 10 hour or 12 hour of battery backup, you can simply see. So after 1% of the battery lose, and you will see it also appear in the Windows as well. video fix your problem, subscribe to the channel and leave a thumbs up. And don't forget to share this video with your friends, colleagues and with your geeky community. So let's meet in another video. Until that, keep updating. Catch you later.